I'm so honored to be here. I'm so humbled by what God is doing here today and yesterday. Amen. Are you excited to receive more from Jesus today? Hallelujah. We're going to go glory to glory today. Amen. God's going to do a new thing. More and more. There's always more. There's always more. If you need more freedom, more healing, it's coming today. If you need more of his spirit, more of his power, more of his anointing, he wants to release it to you today. Hallelujah. Are you ready? Hallelujah. You know, revival is now. There's a prophetic word that was released in LA to our little church. We were small back then. And the prophet actually prophesied to me my calling, and he said, God has sent me from far away to prophesy to you now that God has heard America's prayers and cries for revival. For many years, there's been prayer conferences. It's been a long time since revival, right? And he says, and God has heard your prayers, and he has answered them, and the time for revival is now for America. Amen. Hallelujah. Yes, we need to praise God for that. It is so true. And I was convicted in that moment. This is a true prophetic word. This is a true prophet speaking. And when a true prophet of God speaks, it's the word of God. And I felt convicted to carry this word, to hold on to it. And that God was calling me to repeat it and proclaim it. Like John the Baptist was saying, wake up. You know what's coming? Do you know what's coming? Wake up. It's time to be expectant. Get excited. Revival's now. So I kept declaring that at our church every week since that, pretty much every week since that day, which was about 3 years ago. Revival is now, to our church of about 10 or 15 people. Revival is now. Chantal is the worship leader, and she would say, revival is now. We even wrote a song, revival is now. Your kingdom is here. Let your glory be revealed. Hallelujah. And we weren't seeing what we pictured revival to look like. But we kept declaring, revival's now. And revival had begun. You know, when Jesus was conceived by the Holy Spirit and Mary, hey, revival was now. Right? When he was born, revival was now. But not a lot of people knew. Right? Even when he was in his 20s, revival was now. Jesus was here. The Savior of the world was here, but not many knew. Even when he called his disciples, it wasn't time to yet go and minister to the masses yet. But revival was now. And so that's what it's been like the past few years. We knew what was coming and we believed. And as Jesus said to the disciples, after the Samaritan woman that he ministered to, that he prophesied to, ran passionately and told the testimony of Jesus to everyone in the town, as she went and ran and told the news, the testimony, Jesus says to his disciples, you think that harvest time is 3 months from now. But I'm telling you, harvest time is now. Harvest time is now. And I'm telling you, what we've seen, this amazing move of God we've seen online, we've seen in person, people flying every week from around the country, hungry for Jesus. It's harvest time. It's harvest time. And the moment that we can accept this, that we can get in line with God's season of revival, this revival will explode. It will explode through you, through your church, through your community, through your family, in your city. It will explode. When you can get in line with God's season, with his plan, God's going to use you powerfully. And God has called every one of you to be revival carriers, to walk in powerful anointing. This anointing is not for one person, for two people. It's not for Pastor Vlad and Apostle Catherine only. Amen? It's for every one of you. We are all called to cast out demons and heal the sick. Hallelujah. And preach the gospel with power. Every single one of you, this is your calling. And it's time now that the Acts Church is restored to the body of Christ. This is our blueprint of what church would look like. The book of Acts. how church was done, how anointing was released, how anointing was received, how to walk in anointing. We have a blueprint in the book of Acts. We should be going there in the Word of God to see how we should follow Jesus, how we should be real disciples, how we should minister. You know, not what did last generation do? What did the previous church I was in, my parents' church do? What does the Bible say? This revival is going to be the greatest revival of all time. Because in past revivals, they kind of faded, right? We think back to the past revivals. But in this revival, it's not going to fade. It's lasting. Because God is restoring the Acts church to the body of Christ. Right now, deliverance, miracles, power of God is pretty rare in the body of Christ, especially in America. But things are changing now. Jesus is not coming back until the bride is ready, is beautified. Amen? We've got some work to do. We have to look like the Acts church first. That's step one. But then Jesus says, you will do greater things. You will do greater things. So that means we got to go beyond the Acts church. We got to do even greater things than they did through Jesus. Hallelujah. Are you excited? Come on. This is just the beginning. God wants to use you to shock the world. It says, Isaiah 29:14, therefore, once more, I will astound these people with wonder upon wonder. The wisdom of the wise will perish. The intelligence of the intelligent will vanish. In other words, the religious people that think they know what God's like, how he works, what he wants to do, how he wants church to be, it's time for their wisdom to perish. The wisdom of this world. He's speaking about religious people. And the intelligence of the intelligent to vanish. It's time. It's time for things to drastically change. For us to not be the minority anymore. No, it's time for a big change, a big turnaround. Hallelujah. For it to be the norm, for people to be on fire for Jesus, to really know him, how amazing he is, that he loves you so much, he wants to heal you and deliver you, that he's not a God of condemnation or shame or judgment. Amen. So in order for God to make this wisdom of this world perish, God has to astound the people with wonder upon wonder. How is God going to astound the people with wonder upon wonder? Well, God chooses to use vessels. Amen? How did God astound and show that he was with the Israelites? In the times of Moses, he put his anointing, his mighty anointing in Moses. And he astounded the people through his vessels, through his obedient vessels. His power was unleashed. Amen? Through the apostles, through the ministers, through the people in the book of Acts, he put his anointing in them. This is God's way of moving. He does the miracles through his vessels. He says, you heal the sick. You cast out demons. You baptize. You speak, you preach the gospel, you. I've given you the authority. So in order for God's plan right now, this is Rhema prophetic word of what God's doing in this season, this wisdom of this world vanishing. In order for God to do that, he needs to use you. He needs to use willing vessels to astound the people in this world. Hallelujah. God's called you. I see a lot of usable vessels here. The Bible says that the pure in heart shall see God. Those who are not pure cannot see God, cannot recognize God, cannot hear from God. I see pure hearts here. The only ones who can really be used by God are pure and childlike hearts. As I shared yesterday, that secret of how to walk in anointing, of how to receive the revelation, of how to walk in authority, is by being childlike and humble. As it says in Luke 10, 21, I praise you, this is the Passion Translation, I praise you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because you've hidden these things from the wise and learned and revealed them to little children. Yes, Father, for this is what you were pleased to do. That's the NIV version. The Passion Translation says, this is what pleases your heart, to give these things to those who are like trusting children. You've hidden the great revelation of this authority from those who are proud, those wise in their own eyes, and you have shared it with these who have humbled themselves. This is the key. If I could give you the biggest key, the biggest secret of how to walk in anointing, how to receive anointing, it is this right here. To humble yourself. And humble yourself some more. And humble yourself some more. And get as low as you can. To become childlike. This is only how you can see God. This is only how God can entrust you with this precious, powerful anointing. This is only how God can get the glory. Is when we see who we really are. We see how insignificant we are compared to God. Who are we to think we know it all? Who are we to think we know exactly everything about God and how he wants church to be and ministry to be? Who are we to be so rigid in our minds? This is what God says. This is how God thinks. God told me, with that attitude of pride. Amen. I want to share with you what it means to be childlike. What does it mean to be childlike? Children are not skeptical or critical. You have the childlike and you have the Pharisees. The childlike are as far away from the Pharisees as possible. Pharisees were so skeptical and so critical. They thought they knew how God was exactly. They knew the Bible inside and out, the Word of God at that time. They knew it inside and out. They studied day and night. But they didn't leave any room for God to teach them a new thing. They were rigid and prideful in their minds. I am wise, is how they saw themselves. When it comes to spiritual things, I know it all. But that is not what children are like. We're talking childlike, not childish. Childlike. Now, the world's way thinks that children, that childlike is not a good thing. In the world's way, the wisdom of this world is to protect yourself, to be skeptical, to be critical. That's wise in the world. Right? But not in the kingdom of God. It's the opposite. We do not protect ourselves with criticism and being skeptical. When we do that, we are being wise in our own eyes, and we are literally putting blinders over our eyes and blockers over our ears. We are making it so God has to hide things from us. When we protect ourselves through criticism and being skeptical. But we don't need to protect ourselves. God is the one who should be protecting us, who we should seek all of our protection from. Amen? The most wise people in this world are those who are childlike. That's true wisdom. So that, let me tell you what that looks like. Let me give you an example on my life. And it's how I got here to this point. I was a Christian my whole life. I grew up in Presbyterian church. Never missed hardly any Sunday my whole life. When I got to my 20s, I moved out to LA. Out of my tiny town, I now found huge, big churches. And it was the kind of churches that didn't know that the power of God existed, right? That's where I was, and I was serving in every area possible. And that's all I knew of God, was that experience right there. Was God without power, not a miracle-working God. All I knew was there are pastors. I didn't know there were prophets and apostles and all the fivefold ministry. I didn't know demons existed today. I didn't know deliverance existed today. I knew nothing. I didn't know about baptism of the Holy Spirit. I didn't know about anointing. I didn't know about the authority we have. All I knew was the typical lukewarm Christian, mainstream, you know, Christian way, theology, doctrine. But I was hungry for God. The Bible says that when you seek me and seek me with all your heart, then you will find me, God says. So I hadn't found all of God yet. And God is so big that there's always more of him to be found. Amen? No matter how old you are, no matter how long you've been a Christian, no matter how long you've been in ministry, come on, God is the creator of this universe. He's been around a lot longer than we have. Amen? There's a lot more of him to be found. But he's only found when you seek him. To seek means that you've emptied yourself out. You've humbled yourself out to know that there's more and that you don't know it all. That's what to truly seek is. So I was hungry. I had this feeling there's got to be more. There's got to be more. So that hunger led me to seek and seek. And that led me to accept an invitation to a little tiny house church. 30 or so people crammed in this little living room. Tiny, tiny house. And the minister there was a prophet. I didn't know prophets existed today. He was from a different country. Everyone there, it looked like almost everyone there was from a different country. Didn't look like me. Different culture than me completely. But I came hungry. And not judging and not being critical, like my culture's the only normal one. No, I came emptying out myself, open to learning something new about God, to receiving something new from God. I came there with an open heart. And I see this passion for God like I've never seen in people around me. I saw the fruits like I've never seen before. Next, I see demons trembling and being cast out for the first time, and I see people being healed, and I received a prophetic word for the first time in my life. And when I heard that, I went from believing in God to knowing that he is so real and he's so good and he loves me intimately, me. And his plans for me are good. I always believed that, but I never knew it deep down. In that moment, I really met God. I fell in love with him because I actually really met him. Because Jesus comes in power. The kingdom of God is not a matter of talk, but of power. Before, it was just Jesus talking version that I was getting. The talking about Jesus version I was getting. But now I had really met the Jesus who comes in power, who demonstrates his love and power in action. And so I couldn't help but fall in love with him. I couldn't help but surrender everything because I had really met him. I received the baptism of the Holy Spirit 1 month later there. And I was set on fire. I was never the same since. I had tried to surrender for years. I had one foot in the world for years. I tried to surrender. I wasn't changing. I was going to that church without the power, unchanged. But just one moment in the true presence of God, really meeting Jesus, it wasn't a choice to surrender. It was all I wanted. And I was set on fire, and I've never been the same since. The surrenders increased, the fires increased. That was 6 years ago. But you know what? If I had come to that little house church without the pure childlike heart, I would not be here today. If I came like the Pharisees did, this is different. I've been a Christian my entire life. This is completely different in every way than how I've experienced church in the past. Prophet? My parents are Christian. My grandparents are Christians. They never mentioned about a prophet. What is this? Speaking in tongues? What is this? Then one thing leads to another. One thing leads to another, and then I could start being like, demons? This is weird. And I could have closed off my eyes and closed off my ears to see God right in front of me, giving me the most precious gift in this entire world, the real Him, a real intimacy relationship with Him. But I came with a childlike heart. I came open. God, You can do whatever You want. You can teach me something new. You can do a brand new thing. It was completely different than anything I've experienced. But I knew that I knew that I knew that it was Jesus. It was Jesus like I've never experienced in my entire life. It says the pure in heart shall see God. It says that God reveals these things, the secrets, the kingdom, Himself, to those who are childlike. So this is why it's the most wise thing in the world for you to humble yourselves and become like a child. Because then you can recognize God where He's at. Then you can respect and revere and honor Him rather than grieve Him, disrespect Him, blaspheme His Holy Spirit. That's what the Pharisees did. Jesus is casting out demons by the power of Satan, and they were convinced. And it's a serious deal what I'm telling you. It breaks my heart to see people who really think that they're following God literally blaspheming the Holy Spirit by speaking against true servants of God. Let me tell you, we are never called to do that. As right as you think you are, let God deal with them. And you pray for them, and you stay focused on the work that God's called you to do. God lifts the humble. He opposes the proud. He'll take care. You want to be lifted for His glory so He can use you? Then you stay humble. You have to empty yourself out, which means, this is key to be childlike. What does that mean? The big key is to empty yourself out, meaning everything you've learned about God, everything you know about God, everything you know about church, everything you know about what it means to be a Christian, put it like before God, like lay it in your hands and surrender it and say, God, whatever is wrong doctrine, whatever is religious, whatever is not of You that I've learned about You, I give You permission to take it out. I give You permission to confound me, to show me that I was super wrong. I give You permission. Who am I? You're God. I'm not trying to be smart as You. Amen. A child doesn't come with that attitude to the teacher, to the adult. They are teachable. I know nothing. Teach me. And I'm willing and happy to learn. That's what being childlike is. You know, when I first encountered the power of God, I started learning these things I never heard about before. Fivefold ministry, prophets exist today, anointing, I never heard about anointing before, walking in authority, the power of Your words, life and death is in Your... I started learning all these things I never heard about before. Demons exist today, we can cast out demons. Prophecies for today. I started learning these things I never had my entire Christian life of 25 years. But I came like this to God. I'm not trying to hold on to anything. God, you can have your way. And God had to remove almost everything. Yeah, it was mostly religion that I had learned. I thought he was a condemning God for so long. I thought he was judging me when I didn't open up my Bible. I thought he was so mad at me. For so long, I would listen to that condemning voice, and there would be preachings that would come with the spirit of religion rather than the love and compassion of Jesus. These things that we've learned, these things, we got to put them before God and allow him to have his way, allow him to take out what he wants to take out. No matter how long you've been a Christian, no matter how long you've been in ministry, that's when God can use you. Hallelujah. 1 Corinthians 1:26. Brothers and sisters, think of what you were when you were called. Not many of you were wise by human standards. Not many were influential. Not many were of noble birth. But God chose the foolish things of the world to shame the wise. God chose the weak things of the world to shame the strong. God chose the lowly things of this world and the despised things and the things that are not to nullify the things that are, so that no one may boast before him. It is because of him that you are in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God can only use the weak and foolish things. That's why he chose the nobodies, the tax collectors, the fishermen. He didn't choose the Pharisees that went through Bible school and had the family history of being in church and everything, who knew it all. He chose the people that know nothing about the spiritual realm, nothing. He says, I can use them because they see their weakness in spiritually. They see they don't know anything, so I can use them. They'll keep on relying on me. They'll keep on looking to me. And when God called me, I was like, what in the world? I mean, I felt like I knew nothing spiritually. I looked at ministers and I was like, wow, put them on pedestals, you know? So God called me to be a minister and I felt so weak. Not only was public speaking my biggest fear and weakness, but another one of my biggest fears and weaknesses was to lead a group of people. In college, I would never step up to lead a group of people. I didn't know how to, I was scared. So God called me in my absolute weakness area in every area. And it didn't make the most sense at first to me because I don't see many examples of that except for in the Bible, you know? Because we haven't. But now God's doing a new thing, amen? But now I see, looking back, I see, oh wow, God knew what he was doing. Because every Sunday I would show up to church for years and I would feel so weak. I would feel like, I don't know if I have the words. I don't know if people will be blessed. I felt so inadequate. Every Sunday for literally about 3 years, pretty much until about last year, I still don't feel super confident all the time. I feel weak, but I'm glad. I want to stay there. Because all of those Sundays, I was, for the first time in my life, I was forced to really lean on God. I wanted to be a singer. I got this. I'm good at singing. I could easily forget that I needed God. But with preaching, I knew I needed him. I saw my weakness. So every day, it forced me to look to him and rely on him and remember, I need him. I need him. I cannot do this without him. It's him who's called me, who's put me here before these people, just 15, but that's a big deal. They're special people to him. They're important to him. It's him who's given me the ability to speak. It's him who's put the power in me, an anointing in me that makes miracles to touch people. So every Sunday I would say, God, I need you. I'm so weak. I had to rely on him. That's what being childlike is. Constantly being there, constantly knowing there's more to learn. And God can teach me how He wants. There's so many people that want to hear God their way. God told me in my prayer closet only. But then God speaks through a person, a mentor, a minister, forget it. Oh, God didn't tell me that. Yeah, God told me something different. But many times God chooses to speak a word through a vessel and is seeing if you're humble and childlike and didn't tell you it in the prayer closet. He chose to speak through the vessel. That's what happened to me. It was a way that God tested me. God tested me many times, my childlikeness and humility. One of the big ways He tested me, first it was at that little house church, but second was when I went to a conference 9 months later is when a different prophet prophesied to me, you are called to be an apostle. I did not have any dreams or visions of being an apostle. Don't get me wrong, God chooses to speak to many people in that way, to reveal callings that way. But for me, oh no, I never had any indicator I was called to be a minister. There was only one person a couple months prior to the prophecy. It was a friend I prayed for, and it's because I had learned about praying with authority for the first time. And I prayed for her, and she says, Catherine, you should be a minister. But that was the only person my entire life that said anything remotely close to, you should be a minister. Look at God. He chose to use a vessel to speak through me, and I had to be humble and childlike to receive it. Yes, this is God speaking to me right now. I receive it. Amen? You have to be open to receiving from God however He wants to give to you. Teach you however He wants to teach you. Speak to you however He wants to speak to you. We can't be like, I have to hear God this way. No, we need to be teachable and childlike. Jesus, however you want to teach me. However you want to teach me, Lord, I surrender. Amen. Hallelujah. So God's looking for people who are after His heart. After His heart. Not, I want to look spiritual. I want to look important. I want to be this way. But after His heart. God, I understand that you need me to be childlike and humble. God, I just want to be in your will. I just want to please you. I just want to touch your heart. That's all I care about. I don't care how people see me. I don't care if I have a platform or not. All I care about is pleasing you. That's when God can choose you. That's when God can use you. And everyone will disqualify you, but God will qualify you. David was disqualified by everybody, counted out, didn't look fit for the job as anointed king. But God says, man looks at the outward appearance, but I look at the heart. The only criteria for being used powerfully by God is for you to have a heart after God's own heart, which is a pure heart, which is a humble heart, which is a childlike heart. Simply, period, that's it. That's it. So many people ask me the secret. How much do you fast for demons to be cast out? You know, so many people ask me, what do you do? It's this, simply this. This is the secret. To be childlike and humble yourself and humble yourself again and again and again. And practice that in all areas of your life, that you wouldn't gossip, that you wouldn't speak against people. You wouldn't speak against men or women of God, to anybody. Be humble and childlike before the Lord in every area, not just in front of people, every area. That's when God sees, I can trust you with anointing. We got to have that heart of, I just want to be trustworthy for God to be able to use me, for him to be able to deposit anointing in me. That's it. We don't need to focus on how do I be a good preacher. I need to make sure I read the Bible front and back a million times. I need to fast for this certain amount of days or this routine, this religion. The classes, I got to make sure I do all of this. And then God could use, I got to figure out how God can use me. I'm telling you, it's simply this. And God does the rest. Simply be childlike and humble. Simply be that vessel that God can entrust that anointing in you. So you don't have to do much. You can just come and the demons tremble because of the anointing in you. You don't have to have a lot of physical force, effort, struggle, say the right words a certain way, do a certain thing, No, God does it. God gets the glory because his power can be released. We step out of the way with our own efforts of doing things. We focus on being a usable vessel, a trustworthy vessel who can carry this anointing. So Jesus can do the most through us. Amen. Hallelujah. Come on, we are going from glory to glory now. God is doing a new thing. He's restoring the Acts church, which we have not seen at all. I mean, we've seen a small percentage right now compared to what the Acts church looks like in the body of Christ right now. The past generations, we haven't seen really the Acts church. So that's an indicator that we've got a lot of learning to do from God in the spiritual realm. There's a lot of secrets that are to be released. Amen? Because God wants to take us higher, not just where we've been. He wants to do a new and bigger thing. Amen. Hallelujah. God is so proud of you, all of you who are here. He wants you to know how proud he is of you because you are so rare. You are so rare. The fact that you accept his Holy Spirit, that you're not afraid of demons screaming and manifesting, but you think it's beautiful because it's the sound of freedom. Amen. That you're here two nights in a row hungry for him. You know, you are rare and precious gems. You are the weak and foolish things that God is choosing to confound the wisdom of this world. All of you have all it takes to be used powerfully by God if you'll just be humble and childlike. You have everything. You have everything. And God is counting on you. He wants you to know this is a serious responsibility. This is a serious call. You're all carrying anointing when you're part of an anointed church and when you're anointed ministry, even tuning in online, you're receiving anointing. You're carrying anointing. Value that. And take it seriously. Show God you value this anointing. You value that he's called you. I remember when God first called me and I knew anointing started to work in my life. I wasn't seeing big miracles yet at all, but I know how this works in the spiritual realm. I know anointing's begun to flow in me 5 years ago. I took it seriously, like everywhere I went, there's anointing in me. I'm going to be really careful over my words to only speak life and not death. I'm going to be really careful how to use my authority to not abuse this anointing. To make sure that does not come out of me, but it can only increase. I take this very seriously. I never want to grieve the Holy Spirit. I only want to please him every single day. I'm only going to love my neighbor. They're mean to me. I'm going to make it my biggest effort to love them and only speak nice, kind things to them because I value this anointing that God's given me. This was years ago. When there was just a handful of people in the church, I took it so seriously. Start taking this seriously right now, where you're at. so that God can increase you and use you so powerfully. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You can stand to your feet. God's ready to release his anointing. It's his plan now to set you free. Those of you that need freedom, those of you that need healing, God wants to bring this abundant life to you now so he can use you to the fullest capacity. So he can put the most anointing in you to use you the most powerfully. He wants you to be completely free and healed because he loves you, so he can get the glory through the abundant life that you're walking in. And so he can use you more because the devil's not holding you back and you don't have chains on you anymore. Hallelujah. So it's time to receive this precious anointing. Amen. This anointing of Jesus to destroy every yoke. It heals every single sickness. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. God is going to start releasing his power. It's going to make demons tremble. If that is you and you feel this manifestation, make your way to the front, because it is like getting under Apostle Peter's shadow. We're just getting under the shadow. That anointing would make the demons flee and the sick healed. And we saw that even last night. There was a woman who was walking forward, and as soon as she came to the front, she fell back with the power of God, and God set her free right there. A word wasn't even spoken to her. She just fell back because the anointing hit her. God's anointing is here. Amen. Are you ready to receive? Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. God is breaking generational curses now in families right now. And if you are here with a family member and you've noticed this oppression in your life, there's some people that speak about how they don't feel close to their daughter. They don't feel like they can love their daughter well, naturally. And her grandmother felt the same way about her, or the mother felt the same way about her mother, and the grandmother the way about her mother. They were set free of a generational curse, and now they're able to love each other naturally. It comes naturally, this love. This was a generational curse, and so many things that don't seem right in your life, it's because you need freedom from that. Freedom from that generational curse. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I declare every generational curse to be broken now in Jesus' name. Off of every person, off of every family now. Every generational curse of sickness, of cancer, of infertility, I break it now in Jesus' name. Every generational curse of addiction, I declare it to be broken now in Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. I declare spirit of infirmity must leave every person now in Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Are the hungry ones here tonight? Are the hungry ones here tonight? Hallelujah. It's time to pull upon God. It's time to be hungry. It's time to come before him like a child right now and say, God, do a new thing. I'm willing. I surrender, Lord. Have your way. Deliver me how you want. This is a key to deliverance. You have to You have to surrender. Jesus, have your way in me, my deliverer, Jesus. However it looks like. Let it be public for your glory, Jesus. Have your way. Deliver me how you want, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Just speak to him now that you surrender, that you desire to be set free how he wants. Surrender you to you, Jesus. We invite you, Holy Spirit, to come have your way completely. Deliver your people how you please, Jesus. We give you permission. May you be glorified in this place right now. Do a new thing, God. We invite you to confound the wisdom of this world now. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. You in the USA, can you come forward? God is setting you free right now. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. God is freeing you right now. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I declare every demonic spirit that's come and attacked her in her mind and attacked her body, attacked her relationships. On three, every one of you must leave her in Jesus' name. One, two, three. I break every generational curse off of her now in Jesus' name. I break every demonic soul tie off of her now. Every demonic spirit that came in through people, through abuse, out of her now in Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. God is freeing you right now, hon. Is there anything God is leading you to renounce? Any open doors?
I went and I saw a psychic when I was a late teen, a young adult. Abuse, trauma, a lot of trauma. The most important people in my life have all been addicts. I haven't been an addict, but I've have broken family because of it, and I feel the enemy really strong since I became a believer a year and a half ago. Just demonic thoughts. Self-harm has been an issue when I was a young adult, teenager. Just the enemy has been putting thoughts in my head. I'm just ready to be free.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I detach you now from all you renounce. I break every curse of witchcraft off of you. And every demonic spirit now attached to what she renounced, everyone that came in through psychics, everyone that came in through relationships, through these addicts, you must leave her now in the order you entered her, now in Jesus' name. Now. Stop with all of your nonsense and leave her now. 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 You must leave her. What does she owe you? What does she owe you?
Her life.
Allow her to speak. God's freeing you right now, hon. Is there any kind of covenant that you could have made sometimes, some maybe words spoken? That's a key for you to being set free, is renouncing that covenant with the enemy in some way. You can renounce it now. Say, I renounce this, and then speak what it is.
I renounce depression, anxiety, feeling from a really young age that I was unlovable, unworthy, a failure, that I didn't deserve to be loved or well taken care of. Anything I did before being saved, anything I've ever done, I'm sorry, Jesus, I'm really sorry. I just want to please you.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. And do you remember any kind of covenant that could have been made even when you were young, that could have been spoken, and maybe unknowingly, to a demon that maybe you didn't know was a demon?
I just remember a lot of suicidal thoughts. Just at a really young age, I believe I was sexually abused by a family member. I don't know exactly what happened, but I just feel it, and it's hard to explain. It's in my body.
Thank you, Jesus. I detach you now from all that you renounced. I break every covenant, every demonic covenant, now in Jesus' name. Now, on three, every demonic spirit attached to what you renounced, attached to the covenant, attached to what came in through abuse as a child, you all must leave her in Jesus' name. One, two, three. Out now. You have to leave her now. Now. Stop with your nonsense. Leave her now. You have to go, every one of you now. Out now. I break every word curse, every covenant she spoke of giving her life, every suicidal thought, every suicidal spirit, out now in Jesus' name. Now. Every spirit of death, out now. I break every assignment that she would be the devil's, that she would be a servant of the devil. I break every assignment. I break every covenant that was spoken that she would be a servant of the devil. Every one of you connected to that covenant, out of her now. Allow her to speak now. God is going to continue to reveal to you right now more. There's more that needs to be renounced specifically. And if you can think anything in your mind, you could even speak any covenant that you unknowingly made. You can speak, I renounce any covenant I unknowingly made with the enemy. And you can speak this. And I declare in the presence of this anointing in this service today, everyone must leave. So God's going to reveal now. You surrender right now, and God's going to reveal now more. Everything that needs to be renounced. Every key that needs to be unlocked for complete freedom. Thank you, Jesus. Complete freedom to you in the presence of this anointing now. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. praise God. If you're feeling any manifestation, come forward, because God wants to set you free right now. Come here. Come here. Thank you, Jesus. Yesterday, has he renounced the sickness, all the sickness, everything, every kind of open door of the enemy? Yes? Yes. Thank you, Jesus. I break every curse off of him. I detach him from all that he renounced in Jesus' name. And I declare on three, every demonic spirit attached to what he renounced, everyone coming from past generations, everyone bringing sickness in his life must leave him in Jesus' name. One, two, three. Out of him now. Every spirit of infertility out of him now. Every spirit of witchcraft out of him now. And I speak every last trace of sickness to come out. Every spirit of death to go in Jesus' name. Be healed in Jesus' name completely. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. You right here, God is setting you free, and the black mask, come forward. Come forward. God is setting you free right now. Thank you, Jesus. I declare every demonic spirit that was sent to bring her into the world and serve the enemy, every demonic spirit of death, every demonic spirit speaking against her self-worth, every spirit of anxiety, on three, you all must leave her in Jesus' name. One, two, three. Out now. God. Thank you, Jesus. Every spirit of witchcraft out of her now. I break every curse off of her now. Everyone coming in at a young age through abuse, out of her now. Thank you, Jesus. Allow her to speak now. And God is freeing you so powerfully right now. Jesus is setting you free. Is there anything God is leading you to renounce that could have been an open door for the enemy?
I want to serve Jesus, and I have a lot of fear to serve God. And I have had a lot of fear of serving him. And God has spoken to me years ago that I would serve him powerfully, and I've just been terrified to step into ministry because I'm scared of the enemy. I'm scared of his influence, and he has brought so much torment and pain into my family, and I want to serve God. And I don't care.
Thank you, Jesus. Jesus is setting you free from this fear right now. Jesus is more powerful than the devil. There's nothing to fear. Greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. There is nothing to fear. He can't touch you, and he will not be able to torment you after today. A key for you to being set free right now is to renounce that fear. Instead of saying, I am afraid of the devil, to say, I renounce fear I had of the devil.
Okay. I
renounce fear I have of the devil. I renounce the fear I have of him attacking me and attacking my family. And I renounce that in Jesus' name.
Thank you, Jesus. I detach you from what you've renounced now. And I command now every demonic spirit attached to what you renounce, every spirit of fear, every demonic spirit trying to stop her from serving God, everyone coming in her family, you must leave her now in Jesus' name. Complete freedom now, in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Every last one out of her now. Everyone trying to keep her silent out of her now. Now, everyone must leave her in Jesus' name. I break every curse off of her that was sent so that she would not serve God. You all must leave her now, every last one. I speak complete freedom in the presence of this anointing now, in Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. And as God leads you to renounce more, renounce more. God has done a powerful work right now. He has set you free of so much, and he's going to finish the work now as you keep surrendering to him. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Every demonic spirit that speaks condemnation to her in her mind, every spirit of religion, every spirit that speaks against her identity in Christ, everyone that says she's not good enough and that she's lacking. On three, I command all of you must leave her in Jesus' name. One, two, three. Enough. Out now. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I remove every word curse that was spoken to her and every demonic spirit that came in through death, words of death at her must leave now. Thank you, Lord. Allow her to speak now. Hun, God is setting you free so powerfully right now. Hallelujah. Is there anything God's leading you to renounce?
I just had a pastor say that I was working with the devil a couple years ago and that I need to stop. There was no deliverance, no nothing. And
yeah. Jesus. Thank you, Father. I detach her now from this in Jesus' name. And I command every demonic spirit attached to that, every spirit of religion, condemnation, every one of you that came through those words, you must leave her now in Jesus' name. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. You are free. Jesus has freed you. Praise God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God is so proud of you. He delights in you, and you have an amazing heart to be used by him, and that's why the devil tried so hard. You are free to be used powerfully by God today. God says, I've called you. You are beautiful in every way. You are more than enough to be used by me. I have amazing plans to use you. And people are going to be set free from the spirit of religion through you. Demons will be cast out through you. Thank you, Jesus. Receive this anointing now. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. You are amazing, Lord. Every demonic spirit of religion, I command to leave every person here now. Everyone that came through church hurt, through leaders carrying religious spirit, it must go now in Jesus' name. Every demonic spirit that speaks that condemning voice, that you're not good enough, a good enough Christian, that God's ashamed of you or not proud of you, disappointed in you, it must go now in Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. And I remove all of that trauma, all of that hurt that came through those words, those abusive words now. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. God's touching you now. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. God is so proud of you. Yes. He says that he's a man after my own heart. And it's time for every kind of bondage to leave your life now. Because God has big plans for you ahead. Thank you, Jesus. Every demonic spirit that's tried to keep him from progressing forward, everyone attacking his body, on three, everyone must leave him in Jesus' name. One, two, three. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God.
Take the pain.
Thank you, Jesus. I declare every spirit of infirmity to come out now in Jesus' name. I break every generational curse off of you. And every demonic spirit causing sickness and pain must go. I speak complete healing to you now. I speak all of the pain to leave your body now in Jesus' name. All of the pain to leave your heart now. Be healed now in Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Look at Jesus. Look at Jesus. Look at the love of Jesus. There's nothing more beautiful than seeing God touch his people. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. God wants to free you right now.
I need deliverance from lust and from masturbation. And then from depression, anxiety, fear. I hear lies of like the enemy all the time, like constantly. And then also I did make a covenant with a demon for like rage that I forgot about in my past. And also hopelessness.
God wants to free you right now. He's going to free you right now.
Amen.
If you can speak now, I renounce all that I just listed.
I renounce all that I just listed.
And now renounce this covenant and speak exactly what this covenant was. I renounce this covenant that I made with a demon and say what it was.
I renounce this covenant that I made with the demon, asking it for the power to overcome my enemies with rage.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I detach him now from everything he renounced in Jesus' name. I break this demonic covenant that he made now in Jesus' name. I detach him from that covenant now. And on three, I command every demonic spirit attached to what he renounced, attached to this covenant, must leave him in Jesus' name. One, two, three. Out now. Every spirit of lust, every spirit of addiction, every spirit of rage, out now. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. I speak complete freedom to him now in Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. Be filled with this anointing now. Be filled with the power of God. Be full of peace and joy now. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Come here. Come here. God is setting you free right now, hon. Come here. Come here now. Thank you, Jesus. Every demonic spirit of depression, everyone that speaks against her in her mind, everyone that comes at night in nightmares, everyone that's come through friends, through every spirit of rejection, you must leave her in Jesus' name on three. One, two, three. Out of her now. Thank you, Jesus. Hon, God is freeing you right now. This is Jesus touching you. He's begun a mighty work. And for more deliverance, he wants to bring you. A key is to renounce. Is there anything God's leading you to renounce that could have been an open door for the enemy? Anything that wasn't God's will for your life, in your life that you want to renounce?
Depression and self-harm. And
thank you, Jesus.
Unforgiveness.
Thank you, Jesus. I detach you now from all that you renounced in Jesus' name. And I command now everyone attached to what she renounced, every demonic spirit must leave her in the order you entered her now. Every spirit of death, every spirit of self-harm, every spirit of depression, out now. Hallelujah. Complete freedom to her now. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Complete freedom. I speak now. Complete freedom in the presence of this anointing. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Jesus, yes. Thank you, Jesus. God is setting you free right now. Thank you, Lord. Is there anything God's leading you to renounce?
I'm in ministry and I do all, like, I get to travel and preach the gospel, but, like, inside, there's always, like, this feeling. Not enough, like, When you were talking about religion and church and all that stuff, I just started weeping. And I didn't grow up knowing God, but I got saved in 2012. But there's just this constant inside battle. And especially when it comes to worship, I always feel like disqualified in a sense. But I know that that's a calling on my life, and I know that I'm called to preach the gospel and do all these things. And I like pushed through, and I went through so much trauma growing up, but and I'm really good at renouncing and doing all these things. But it's always like I'm like running, and then it's not like outward immoral stuff. It's like inward like lies that will like mess with my mind, that will get me like like just in this weird cycle, and I'm like, okay, I'm gonna declare the word, I'm gonna do this. And it's, I see people get set free from demons, but inside, like, there's just this thing, and I don't know if it's generational, I have no clue. And I was like fighting, because I'm like, oh man, like, but God's like, Ash, what does it cost you? Sometimes it can cost you in your integrity, like, who cares?
Yes.
And so I don't care, I just want to be free.
Amen.
From this internal crap.
Praise God.
Yeah.
Praise God. Do you want to just speak right now in the presence of the anointing where God's power is moving, that I renounce and the thoughts or whatever?
Yeah, Lord, I just renounce every negative thought, every cycle, any comparison, just not feeling good enough, all fear, the fear of the unknown, fear of relationships, fear of all this stuff, Lord, and I just let it go.
Thank you, Jesus. I detach you now from all you renounced. I break every generational curse off of you now. And on three, I command every demonic spirit attached to what she renounced, everyone trying to stop the call of God on her life, trying to silence her voice, attacking her mind all the time, speaking down on her. On three, you almost go. One, two, three. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Every last one must leave her now. Everyone stopping, trying to stop her from preaching the gospel. Everyone stopping her from worshiping. Everyone stopping her, trying to stop her from being lifted for God's glory. Everyone putting a cover over her in the spiritual realm. Out. Every spirit of religion, out now. Enough. Enough. All of you must go now. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Lord, you see, it's the surrender to Jesus that's the key for you to be set free. You know, she says, I don't care how I look, it's all for God's glory. You know, to be look to witness Jesus's love. This is Jesus's love. This gives him glory. This brings us closer to Jesus. This brings the world, those watching online, closer to Jesus. They're set free even watching as God's power is moving. This is when Jesus can set you free, when you surrender and you say, I don't care how you want to deliver me, God. I surrender. Thank you, Jesus. I speak complete deliverance to her now, complete freedom now in Jesus' name. In the presence of this anointing now, every last one must leave her. Now. I break every curse off of her now. Everyone that was stopping her from shining for God, out of her now. Enough. Enough with your nonsense. Every last one out now. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. I declare now every demonic spirit that's been attacking people like this, trying to stop you from being used by God, trying to mute your voice, trying to stop you from worshiping God. You must leave every person here now. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Every demonic spirit that's tried to stop the call of God on his life, that's tried to demean him, everyone coming through other people speaking bad to him, every voice of the enemy saying that he's inadequate, on three, you all must leave in Jesus' name. 1, 2, 3. Break every generational curse off of him now. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. I speak complete freedom to him now. In Jesus' name. Look at me. Thank you, Jesus. Allow him to speak. Allow him to speak. God is freeing you right now. This is Jesus freeing you right now. Thank you, Jesus. As God's power is moving in this presence, is there anything God's leading you to renounce? Be something that you renounced before, but in the presence of where God's power is moving right now.
Yeah. I feel like self-hate more than anything.
Thank you, Jesus.
Just feeling abandoned or like God is disappointed. Just not where I should be. That I've let him down, that I've failed in areas.
Thank you, God. I detach him from what he's renounced now. And I command now every demonic spirit attached to what he renounced, all of the self-hate, must leave now in Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. Every spirit of death must go now. Thank you, Jesus. Every demonic spirit trying to shorten his life. Out now. Enough. Every one of you. Out now. Every spirit of self-harm, every spirit of death thoughts in his mind, every spirit of darkness, out now, in Jesus' name. every last one out of him now. Everyone stopping him from being used by God in power, out now. Complete freedom to him now. Complete freedom now. Every curse of death I declare to be broken off of him now. Every assignment of the devil to take his life, I break it now. In Jesus' name. Allow him to speak. God is setting you free so powerfully right now. Is there anything else God is leading you to renounce that could have been any open door?
Trauma as a kid.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah, sexual abuse.
I detach him from what he renounced now. On three, every one of you that came in through this sexual trauma as a kid, when he was a kid, you all must leave him in the order you entered him through that trauma. One, two, three, out of him now. Jesus. Thank you, Father. I speak complete freedom now to him in the presence of this anointing now. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. You will fulfill God's call on your life. Nothing will stop you. Nothing will stop you. And I remove that blockage that was in front of you. It is gone. You are free now. You are free now. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Nothing can stop God's call on your life. If you will surrender, nothing can stop God's call on your life. Thank you, Jesus. Enough. Every spirit of anxiety, every harassing spirit, every spirit of rejection, every orphan spirit, on three, you all must leave her. Now, in Jesus' name, one, two, three. Out now. Allow her to speak now. God is freeing you right now, hon. Is there anything God's leading you to renounce that could have been an open door?
That I'm incurable. It's so vain. Rejection. So much disease. torment. I've been tormented for so long. In my sleep, and my muscles bite. I get locked by this thing. So much pain. It moves through my body and turns my muscles to cement. And I want to be free from it.
Thank you, Jesus.
I don't want to be locked anymore.
Yes, God is setting you free right now. Thank you, Jesus. I detach her now from all that she renounced. In Jesus' name, I break every curse off of her. And I command now every demonic spirit attached to what she renounced. Everyone messing with her body. Every spirit of infirmity. Every disease. Out of her in the order you entered her now. Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I break every generational curse off of her now. Every generational curse of sickness off of her now. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. I speak complete freedom to her in this presence right now, this presence of God. And I speak all sickness to come out of her body now. Every sickness out now. Every disease out now. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Praise God. Jesus, you are amazing. Jesus, you are amazing. God's setting you free right now. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord.
I renounce people pleasing. I don't even have authority over my own life. It feels like I wake up and I feel like I'm gonna die in the middle of the night. I renounce anxiety, depression, lust. Speaking and believing lies. I'm just done. I'm done being afraid. I want to serve the Lord with everything in me.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I detach you now from all that you renounced. I break every generational curse off of him now. And on three, I command every demonic spirit attached to what he renounced must leave him in Jesus' name. One, two, three. Out now. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. No more thoughts of death from today. No more anxiety from today. Every spirit of anxiety out of him. Every spirit coming in the night. Every spirit of death out now. In Jesus' name. Every spirit stopping him from serving God, out of him now. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus.
I'm done having one foot in the world.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Every one of you must leave him now in the order you entered him. Now in Jesus' name. everyone trying to bring him into the world. Out of him now. Thank you, Jesus. Complete freedom to him now. In Jesus' name. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Be filled with this anointing. I release this power of God to you. Be filled now. Nothing can stop you from serving God. Now. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. God is going to move now and set free every last person here and watching online. It is time to be fully set free. Amen. God is able. We've seen what he's done, and he's not finished yet. It's time right now. We're going to spend a moment right now. Maybe you have renounced before, but right now, where God is moving in power, as God leads things to you in your mind, speak now. We've seen the power of this renouncing, how it is a key. So speak this right now. Speak any words of renouncement that God's leading you to. Everyone watching online, speak now. Any door that was open for the enemy in your life, renounce it now. Thank you, Jesus. Declare God's will over my life. I say no to the devil's will. I say yes to God's will. Thank you, Jesus. I detach everyone here, everyone watching online. I detach you now from all that you've renounced in Jesus' name. I break every curse off of you, every generational curse off of you now. And on three, I command every demonic spirit that was attached to what you renounced must leave now in Jesus' name. One, two, three, out now. Every spirit of addiction, out now. Every spirit of lust, out now. Every spirit that came in through trauma and abuse, out now. I break every curse off of you, every word of death spoken to you, now. Every word of death you spoke over yourself, I break that power now. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. Every spirit of Jezebel must go now. I break every demonic soul tie off of you. I declare every spirit of manipulation that's controlled you must go now in Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. God is freeing you right now. God is freeing you right now. Thank you, Jesus. Is there anything God's leading you to renounce, hon? God is freeing you right now.
I just need a big healing in my life right now. It's emotional and my back. Like, I've had scoliosis for about 10 years now, and it's upcoming to the point where I need surgery, and it's just not okay. And, like, there's just a lot of barriers up with me right now, and it's just...
Holy Spirit, Jesus.
Ooh. Thank you, God. Yes, God is freeing you and healing you right now. That's Jesus. Thank you, Father. I detach her now from all she renounced, from all the sickness and scoliosis. I break every generational curse off of her. On three, I command every demonic spirit attached to what she renounced, every spirit of infirmity, everyone causing the scoliosis, everyone must leave her in Jesus' name. One, two, three. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. I declare healing to you now. I declare your spine to straighten now. In Jesus' name. There will be no need for surgeries. I speak complete healing to you now. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. I speak every sickness must leave every body. Every sickness now. Everyone with fertility problems, be healed now in Jesus' name. Every spirit of mental illness must go now in Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. Every spirit of witchcraft must leave now. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I speak healing to hearts where there has been hurt that's remained with you. Some of you have, it's words that people spoke. I see there's certain family members that spoke very hurtful words and it's remained with you. And it's like memories of just keep coming back of that haunting you. I declare that to leave you now in Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. You here. Come here. God is freeing you right now. Thank you, Jesus. I declare every attack of the enemy, every demonic spirit that's trying to stop him from serving God, everyone that's put a blockage in his path, every voice of the devil that is like a stronghold in the mind, you must leave him on three in Jesus' name. One, two, three. Out now. In Jesus' name. Everyone coming in at a young age, out of him now. Everyone coming in through trauma, out of him now. God is setting you free right now. Is there anything God's leading you to renounce in the presence of where God's power is moving right now?
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
A couple years ago, since we moved here from Idaho, I've lived in a state of backslide from Jesus. I haven't served him faithfully. And in that place of darkness, I've gone behind my wife to commit adultery against her. And my little four-year-old can, she feels it. And she told me, and she said, you need to go to Apostle Catherine so she'll pray for you and you will love me well. And as I've been here, there is generational demonic spirit of sexual promiscuity and adultery and fornication and every kind of sexual sin that is prevalent from my father and my grandfather. And there has even been blood sacrifice, and I'm not sure, maybe human blood sacrifice for to gain power. And I renounce that in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I renounce everything that William's dad did to try to gain power and the way in which he treated women to get power. I renounce that. I renounce the idea of having woman as sexual, just a means to an end and sexual object. I renounce any form of that. I renounce lack of commitment and loyalty to my wife. What was with my father and my grandfather and my entire family, I renounce it. It will not continue in my family.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
I break every generational curse off of you now in Jesus' name. I detach you from all that you've renounced. I break every curse that was sent from past generations upon you. I break every curse of every sacrifice, blood sacrifice now. I break every curse that was sent to your wife now in Jesus' name. There was word said that whoever your wife was, this curse would go to. I break that curse now off of you in Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. On three, I command every demonic spirit attached to what you renounced, every spirit of sexual promiscuity, lust, must leave you, and everyone attached to that curse upon you both must leave on three in Jesus' name. One, two, three. Out now. Allow her to speak now. Hun, God is freeing you right now. This is Jesus freeing you right now. Hallelujah. Is there anything that God is leading you to renounce for complete freedom?
I renounce every word of death and murder over my marriage and over my husband and any rage.
Thank you, Lord. I detach you now from what she renounced. Now, in the order you entered her, everyone attached to what she renounced must leave her in Jesus' name. One, two, three. Out of her. I remove every word of death. I break every curse against this marriage. I break every curse saying that it will fail now. Every spirit of death over you and over this family, over this marriage, out now. I detach you from this family generational curse that was sent to you now. Everyone in the order you entered her, you have to leave her now. Enough. Enough with your nonsense. Leave her now. Every spirit of rage, get out of her now. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. She is free. You are free. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I release this anointing to you both now, to this marriage, to this family now. In Jesus' name, to your child now. In Jesus' name, thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. I break every generational curse off this baby now. And off of this baby, off of the other baby. In Jesus' name, and I speak, God's will must be done for this family. I speak abundant life for this family. You will serve the Lord, and God will use you powerfully as a family. And marriages will be restored. Marriages will be restored. People will be delivered. Couples will be delivered through you. People will know the truth through you and will be set free through you. This is God's plan for your life, to be used mightily by Him in power. Thank you, Jesus. Be filled now with this anointing. Be filled now in Jesus' name. And I speak all of that guilt and shame to go. You are new. The past is gone. God's forgotten your entire past. All of your mistakes, they're wiped away now. You are the righteousness of God. You are pure. You are free. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Jesus, you are amazing. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Childlike, humble hearts here. Are they out here? Hallelujah. Who wants to be used by God to astound the world? God's ready to use you. Thank you, Jesus. I speak this anointing to increase. May you be elevated to a higher level in the spiritual realm. May new revelation come to you now. In Jesus' name, may the secrets of the kingdom be revealed to you. In Jesus' name. May the heart of God, the heart of Jesus, come in you more. That childlike, pure heart, come in you more now. In Jesus' name, I speak doors to open up for you. In all of your callings, in all of your ministries, I speak doors to open up now. May you prosper. May you prosper in your ministry. May you prosper in your business. May you prosper in your family, in your marriage now. May you prosper in your spiritual life now, in Jesus' name. May revival spread through you powerfully now in Jesus' name. I speak people to come to you, to be attracted to you now, and they will be set free through you. They will be healed, and they will meet Jesus through you. I declare doors to open up now for people to come now in Jesus' name. Receive this now in Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. Jesus, thank you for what you have done today. We give you all the glory, Jesus. We thank you for coming in power and setting free your people and healing your people. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.